It's gone, but
yeah. Today, August 6th.
Yeah, I think 6th, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't keep track of the days. What day it is?
We have the game band meeting.
There you go.
Yeah, in the Burger King and Utah University branch. I'm gonna talk about simulation universe hypothesis. And it's simple. You know the movie Matrix?
Right.
After the movie, people can imagine our world would be a kind of fake world.
Okay.
Yeah. Simulated.
Right.
Yeah. Sometimes we can imagine that.
Right.
Yeah. But why we imagine our life and then would be lie and would be fake and simulated.
Right.
Yeah. Like in a computer graphics or game programs.
Right.
But nobody thought about the universe could be a simulation,
right.
Game program.
Okay.
Yeah. There's still people thinking that this universe is real. Yeah.
That's what you're saying, all right.
Yeah. Objective reality, right?
Right?
Objective reality. But these days,
we make reality what it is.
Yeah.
Like reality.
This universe. We still consider this universe.
Right.
As an objective reality.
Yeah.
Yeah. But this days, some new
hypothesis.
Yeah, maybe theories. And they told us this universe can be a kind of simulated computer program.
What? I've heard of it before. Hmm? It's simulated.
Yeah, simulated.
In the perception.
Yeah, or there's something over human beings.
Oh, well, maybe possible, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, they found some proofs.
Okay.
Yeah.
Huh.
This universe is a kind of creature.
Okay.
Yeah. Creation. By someone.
Okay. So we're basically in sort of a program.
Yeah. Whole universe.
Whole universe.
Yeah, our universe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah. And still, they don't know. Our universe is the second world, or third world, or fourth world.
Like the, in that theory, the game that I beat last year, Fantasy Life.
Yeah.
Fantasy Life takes place as your normal adventure game kind of thing.
Mm.
Turns out the person you're traveling with is sort of the goddess. And when you beat the game, you can achieve these god ranks. But to do it, you have to meet the creator. Mm. And then you go up to realm where the creator is.
Yeah.
And the person you're traveling with was a butterfly originally. She transformed into a goddess because she's his daughter.
Yeah.
And so, anyways, in that theory, in the game, he describes it as when you go to meet him, you come out of this little tree in the garden. He's got a whole garden around him, and he's watering them. Each one of the gardens he has inside the plant has a universe, and he's watering it. And he says, "Well, you guys think of me as a creator, because really I'm more like a more advanced being." And you're really inside my garden, I'm watering you. So he's basically creating their realities of sorts.
Yeah.
And so she gives him a hard time. She's all, damn, is it true you pretended to be a god a long time ago? He's all, well, I had to because I was so more advanced than these beings. And they were so primitive that it's all they understood. Plus, I was helped shaping them together to be more civilized.
Oh.
So either way, it's sort of like what you're talking about. Because all the realities of each universe was simulated. They were inside of basically a different bush that he was growing. But inside, it was a massive universe. But when you come outside into his world,
yeah,
it's nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing. It's just the perfect word to explain that. And
because
this theory.
Because we think, for us, we think of it as unlimited, as vast. You know, it's the universe is limited to us.
Yeah, limited to
because
us.
Because we're so small, we're basically like microbes in the sea of the ocean.
Yeah.
But in reality, like you say, if it's simulated, we're basically nothing because there could be something.
Yeah. So everything was programmed.
Kind of like Doctor Who.
Yeah, Doctor Who.
If you ever watch Doctor Who?
Yeah.
He's gone outside of the universe a few times. He's gone outside of the universe and there's pockets of nothingness and then there's another universe. So.
Yeah.
So basically, we're, like you say, we're nothing. We don't. We like the human evolution. Especially when they talk about the universe. They like to start with humans as being the start of the Big Bang Theory. Everything exploded out. But who knows where we are on that, really, the Big Bang Theory. It could have blown up way out here, and we're on the outskirts.
Yeah.
But humans like to think that they're the number one always. So we're the start of creation, everything went out.
That's it.
But as you like you say, like I always think that we're probably nothing compared to whatever's out there. So who knows where it started? It could have started on the other side of the universe. We're on the very edge.
Yeah.
But humans like to think that they're the start of creation, the start of everything. We're the most important thing, and everything else is not as important. So that's why they always say, oh, the Big Bang started with Earth, probably here and blew out.
Yeah.
But for them, they haven't proved it. There's no way to prove that.
Yeah. And this simulation universe, the hypothesis, made in a lot of questions.
Hypothesis, yeah.
Yeah. And if our universe is the second, the creator is the first one.
Yeah, but
the problem is that those possibilities are really low.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, it's in mathematical calculation.
Right.
Yeah. So if we are if we are later than the second universe, and the creator, our universe's creator will be created by someone.
Yeah.
And that someone also will be created by someone.
Right, yeah, I've heard that before. But I always like to think of the universe.
Yeah.
It's more like an ocean. The problem is we're so weak, as in surviving space things. We can't swim far out of our ocean.
Yeah.
We can go far as the moon and farther, but eventually we'll go to Mars, but we're really compared to the ocean so vast that we can't really, we can see, but we can't go anywhere.
Yeah.
We don't have technology. Because recently there was one of the rich nations I don't know if it's India, I can't remember. But any one of the really rich nations wants to jump into the space program. And they want to beat NASA privately going to Mars. I think it's Dubai or something like that. But when they get there, they don't just want to visit Mars, but they want to build a colony there. So people were saying that it's a good idea for other countries, especially countries that have lots of wealth, to think of those kind of possibilities, because it'll start a chain reaction.
Yeah.
And we may get out farther in the universe.
Mm. A chain reaction. Yeah.
Because when you make something private, not government, it's always cheaper. Mm. But if you have a nation that has vast more wealth, because of oil and things in the U.S. does, then it makes it more possibility.
Yeah.
So they want to do it from, I think they said 100 years from now. Because 100 years from now, we should have more technology to hopefully travel out that far.
Yeah.
And colonize. I know Americans want to go there in 2020 or so, or 2030, I can't remember what it was. They just want to visit and go home. And so.
Yeah. And the scientists have stated that we, with better hope, our universe will not the first one.
Well,
or second or third or fourth. Because if our universe would be created one, and that means then, and the first one or second one, yeah, our creators and could make a success.
But have you ever watched American TV show Stargate. SG-1.
Yeah, that's the main time, just a few of them.
If you watch it, not only is there multiple universes, but there's multiple realities. Because in each universe, well, in the theories of my dad's books and philosophy and things, there's also multiple Earths.
Yeah.
Not just two Earths, but there's thousands and thousands of different Earths. Because different universes, there are different realities, and each reality has a different version of Earth. And so in that theory, each Earth has me and you in it, but we may be doing different things in life in each reality in each universe.
Oh.
Because we're not copies of each other. Things may have changed in that reality to alter things. Like certain Earths may be at war, certain Earths may be richer, poorer, have different things that would change our futures. Like in some of the Stargates, they get to travel to other realities of their Earth, or people come from their reality to their reality.
Oh.
And they stay there temporarily, and they say, we need some help, because in our reality of Earth, some